I'm going to talk about Node.js, and more than that, I'm going to talk about a framework which is mproject. So mproject, with the help of a build tool called Espresso, we are able to and PhoneGap, we are able to generate native applications out of the HTML5 and JavaScript. So let me talk about the mobile stack. So one of the ways in which you have a web portal where you have a bunch of good number of visitors coming. So nowadays, as it is essential that you have a mobile web, because they'll be accessing it from the smartphones. So that is first step, that you have a mobile website for your site. Otherwise it will look really clinky, and that is not a good user experience. They'll never come back to your site. Another thing which is there, I think it started in 2007 with Apple's iPhone. I'm a great admirer of it, although now I think Android has overtaken it, and it has much more capabilities than iPhone. So App Store. App Store, it enabled the discovery. So that is the so you want your applications, native applications on Apple, on the Android market, on BlackBerry, on other things. So how do you go about it? So one of the ways which you can do, which we did actually initially, so we use Java to produce a native application in Android. How many of you here done Java programming in native for Android? Okay. So yeah, so basically any mobile app developer, like in terms of native app here. Okay, I have one. Okay. So what about like web developer? I think that would be the majority, everybody, right? So what if I told you, so since you are already a web developer, you're also a mobile app developer. So that is what I am going to talk about today, and hopefully I'll be able to show if I'm able to get the network on same network as my laptop, then I'll be able to show you how you can build native app. So what we started with, so build Java Android app, and it was directly talking to the platform. So in our platform, it could be emitting some kind of JSON or something, and that would be used to show a search, and then the views, and there are nice effects, like there is infinite scroll, then there is a shake feature. For example, if you want to go to the next listing, you can just do a shake and you can go there. So we started looking at but this model, it requires first of all, it requires a submission to the App Store, and then it requires the approval process, and it requires separate app in different, possibly in different programming languages, to be built for each platform submission. And then I don't know if you have heard, sometimes they have processes by which it takes, might take 3 to 4 weeks, and your app might get rejected as well. So that is where the mobile web comes into picture. So once you have a mobile web, there is no barrier. You bypass the manufacturer, Apple App Store operator, and everybody. And but you need to popularize it. So that is another thing. So there, there are other things, SEO, SEM, which come into picture. But let us come, how with one code base, you are able to, using Node.js, you are able to produce a website
a mobile website, and you are able to also convert it into the apps, native apps, and you can also submit it to the App Store. So there, obviously, you know, so you know, with so much options available, you need to make a choice, you know, what you want to go with. So if you are developing games, etc., I think there is a session at 4 or something that on games. I mean, you can develop quite good amount of capabilities, but a lot of graphic capabilities would be missing. Things like accelerometer, access to geolocation, and other things. They have started coming into HTML5 and W3C specifications, but we are still not there yet. So the next best thing is the platform. So the platform can be written in whichever backend programming languages that you want. You know, you can use servers like Apache or even Nginx. And the second stack which I'm going to talk about, so this can be used to serve the web. And the second stack which I'm going to talk about is mobile server. So for mobile server, Node.js can be used. And so Node.js alone itself might not be a great idea when it comes to doing heavy lifting at the backend with databases, because it is still in 0.67 stage. I mean, there are good advantages to it. I think in later sessions we are going to talk about how Node.js you know, it scales well. Then there are patterns and practices. Okay. So what is written behind is PhoneGap. So this is what PhoneGap gives me. So instead of writing Objective-C code for Apple, Java code for Android, and Java code again for BlackBerry, for Palm, and for Windows Phone, other languages. So instead of that, you write a single code base, JavaScript, HTML5, CSS3, and compile them separately for this using PhoneGap. So I'm going to show a live demo of PhoneGap also. Meanwhile, you know, so this is where you will get all the information. So PhoneGap recently was acquired by Adobe, and they have open sourced it. I mean, it was already open source, but they have moved it to Apache now, and it's called Callback. There are good pieces to learn about it. So now, I think the PowerPoint which is on Google Docs is much better than this, because I've just downloaded it from there, and somehow it did not come out well. So as far as setup is concerned, so let me talk a little bit, let me come back. So where does M project come into picture? M project comes into picture at this stage to it's a wrapper on jQuery mobile. So web developers out here, like how many of you are familiar with a JavaScript library, say jQuery? Okay, that's a majority. Okay, great. So yeah, so now M project is a wrapper around jQuery mobile, and that can be used. I mean, that can be used along with Espresso. I'm going to just show it live demo. Espresso to generate code in JavaScript, and then you can put things in. This is very similar to I asked, not many people were familiar with Espresso. So Espresso is quite similar to code scaffolding in Ruby on Rails. So it can be used to generate model view controller. Okay, so as far as setup is concerned, I don't think we have high speed internet here, otherwise we could have done this. You need to set up PhoneGap. the when you set up PhoneGap, it comes with Android, like five different platforms, which I just talked about. Then you can download the mProject sample apps. There is a commercial company which is supporting it, so it is it's great. You know, I think support will be there for a long time. There's one thing, if you look at LinkedIn's mobile stack, it's a hybrid one. So for iPhone, I don't know what framework they used, but they were not able to provide the infinite scroll for the listings. So that can be possible. I mean, we have not yet open sourced it, but there's like one plugin which we have written for mProject. It allows you to do infinite listing. So that is really cool. Let me see if I'm able to access like now I'm connected to net, but if I'm able to access the API of JustDial, the company I work for, then I'll be able to show that to you in the emulator. Otherwise, so you get the wind basically. So you go on and install Espresso also. So Espresso, it's fantastic too. So let me explain why I say so. So Espresso, it's a code generator. It's a build tool. It's a deploy tool. It uses Node.js, and it complements mProject very well. So this stack, I recommend it. It can be used independently also. Many people have used Hudson to do a lot of manual things which are involved here. Hudson, by the way, it's used in the Java world. So once we have cloned the Espresso, you need to do these steps. You need to get into Espresso and update all modules. Then you know, you can alias Espresso to wherever Espresso.js is, and bingo. So next, in the command line, when you type Espresso space help, you'll get what Espresso can do. Okay, yeah. So this is one small thing. So you know, in order to install Node.js, you can install it using YAML. And once you do that, in the latest version of Node.js, although it is called Node.js, but Espresso refers to it as Node. So you might want to you know, make a symbolic link. So whatever steps I am giving here, they're for Linux. You can Google steps for Windows and for Mac. By the way, another thing, like Microsoft is putting a lot of weight behind Node.js. There's a sponsored talk later in the day, how it works well with Windows Azure. I think unlike 1990s, etc., when you know, so again, they're sponsoring this and everything. So you know, in late 1990s, they would take a standard like JavaScript, they'll produce their own JScript, and they'll not go with the standard. But this time, you know, it is they're making really good effort into following the standard, which is great. I mean, you know, so that's I think huge advantage. So that is another reason, you know, Node.js is gaining popularity, and because a lot of heavyweights have put their like efforts towards it. So another thing, I'm going to show the Android build. So for that, you know, you need to install the ADT plugin in within your Eclipse. Okay, it didn't really come well, but yeah. Anyways, yeah. So I talked about it already. You know, so mProject is a wrapper for jQuery framework, jQuery mobile framework. It does use HTML5 and CSS3. I think CSS should be above. Then there is tool Espresso, and with which you can generate all these three things, nice things. So let me just do a quick demo of Espresso, how it can be used to generate things. I think quite a bunch of ROR developers here, so it's similar to code scaffolding. Stop the slideshow.
That's good.
Let me stop. Yeah. So thank you. Okay. There's Aptana Studio. When I'm pulling it there, it shows up briefly there, then it comes back to my window. Okay, go there.
Perhaps you can just make both screens the same.
Yeah. I can clone the desktop.
Right.
Yeah. Let me do something. So that's fine. Let me. Now things are difficult because I'm not able to see whatever is on the screen here. So that's fine. Let's proceed because I think we are running out of time. So I do have a couple of projects, but what we are going to do, we are going to see Espresso Magic. Okay. Hold on. Okay. So these are the things. So first thing which I'm going to do is like code scaffolding. So you can use help in it. It gives you. So I'm going to use an example. If you want to start with a blank one, you don't want to give minus e, and you want to give minus e. That is fine, but I mean I am giving the option that is there.
Just remove the equal sign.
Remove equal sign?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah, correct, correct, correct. Yeah, yeah. Here we go. Okay, great. So now, I mean, we can import this into actually, I mean, the way I do it, I generally import into the Aptana Studio and I start modifying it. Let me try once more. Okay, so I think if it is more than 50%, it comes here. So that is, let me maximize it. Okay, great. So I mean, we can import it as a project. And where's my mouse? So you can import it as a project and you can start modifying it. So basically, you know, Espresso, what it has done, it has generated like for the M project, it has generated the because, so I'll just show you. So it puts M project in it. So the M project files, they are put here. Now you know, the controller model and resources are there. You can modify them, and then yeah. Now you can build it. Yeah, sure. Okay, just 5 minutes. So let me just quickly go to the directory. Let me run it. So I'm going to run it as a web app on the Node server. This is for testing. So it has started running. Link. Okay. So here we go. So we have used, you know, like local storage here, and you know, right now we are viewing it as a web app. Same thing can be deployed as mobile web app. You need to put CSS, separate CSS for each phone. And you can deploy it on the Node server. I wanted to, like there is a bunch of things like how you can use JSON to connect with your like service, and you can you know, you can do cool things over here. So, but with interest of time, I think I'm going to skip all that. But happy hacking! I would like to take any like. Last minute questions if you have. It is a little bit incomplete, but I'm happy to answer you know, over the email and over the course of today. Okay, in that case, let me wrap up. Thanks a lot for being a patient listener.